Well, hey there, church family. Welcome to another MCC Moment. My name is Pastor Matt. We're just in the next couple of minutes, I'm going to be just sharing with you and talking with you what I believe God has laid upon my heart for us for the next season and within the life of MCC as well. I just want to highlight last Sunday. Last Sunday was Compassion Sunday, where we had Matthew Hand from Compassion Australia come and share with us, which was just absolutely so priceless and so amazing. And can I tell you, Matthew talked about a young boy who'd been waiting over 2 years, over 600 days to be sponsored. And as a result of last Sunday, that young man was sponsored. And it's just, all of last Sunday was made worth it just because he has been sponsored. He's going to get meals, he's going to get fed, he's going to get educated, and his life is going to be transformed because you responded. And I just want to congratulate you all as a church, because it's just so exciting to be a part of changing other people's lives for the better. And it's just super exciting to see us reach far and wide. And I know, you know, there is that saying that the light that shines the farthest shines the furthest, the farthest, the light that shines the farthest shines the brightest at home. And so for us, mission is absolutely so important. And I'm reminded about the scripture that Jesus, the word that Jesus shared at the Great Commission. So co-mission, so that's working at a particular mission in cooperation with others, co-mission. And Jesus said this in Matthew chapter 28, verse 18. He says, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them," with some noisy cockies, "baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I've commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." And see, that is a promise. There is so much that is within a name, so much power that is within a name. You carry your own special name. There is no other name there's no other person like you, and therefore there is no other name and person like you. You carry your own special name. My name is Matthew, that means gift of God. And so whenever I am thinking about my name, I'm always reminded of the fact that I was a gift from God to family and also to those that I meet. In the same way, God has names. Jehovah Rapha is a name. And that name that is given to God is translated as, "I am the God that heals you." And you see, it's very important that we put these two scriptures together, because number one, the Great Commission is the cooperative mission that Jesus has us, that together we are commissioned, and together with him we are commissioned. Why? Because all authority has been given to him, and all authority has been translated from him for us to co-labor and co-mission with him. Now, why is it important that that name has been given to him? Because another name for God, another name, is Jehovah Rapha. I am the God that heals. And there is a promise in that. The promise is that he heals you, and as you co-mission, as you co-labor with him, then he works in you to see others healed as well. And see, this is the new series that we are going into as a church. I believe that God spoke to me at the end of last year and said that he is positioning MCC to be part of a major healing movement here within this nation of Australia, and particularly within our region. Now, we can't do that unless we learn what it is to operate in healing. We learn what it is to help others be healed. And we're going to be going into this series really seeking and looking for an activation of healing in your life, in my life, and that would translate into entire communities. And that's not just physical, it's spiritual, emotional, it's in every aspect of life. But why? Because God's name is Jehovah Rapha. He is the God that heals, and he is the God that heals us. And he looks to heal us in every single way. So I hope that's an encouragement to you. And you know, I know that Melbourne is in lockdown at the moment. So I would encourage you, pray. Step into prayer. Continue to pray. pray for our leaders, pray for our government, and continue to believe that Jesus will have his way in this great nation of Australia. God bless you. See you soon. Bye for now.